Click on Create Edit Scenario and wait until a SmartMeter.io editor starts. We're going to open the scenario we recorded before. Let's now have a look at the workbench, where we can find a recording log, which we'll be using later for assertions. In this test, we'll be using 20 virtual users with a 60-second ramp-up time, which will hold for 120 seconds. There are several options you can use, so you can modify the scenario for your specific needs. The test duration is going to be set to 3 minutes. Let's now set some assertions, which will be used to check if the test is running correctly. In the recording log, you can find results, requests, and response data. In our case, we'll be looking at response data, which contains the HTML code of the website. When setting assertions, you'll need to look for a unique element, for instance, the HTML tag title. Assertions are added by right-clicking on the relevant step, that is, the one title comes from. So right-click, navigate to assertions, and choose one of the offered possibilities. The same steps need to be repeated for the second transaction. If you forgot to add think times, or you want to change the time, now is the right moment. Place think times between transactions, not into them. Now, let's add a listener called ViewResultsTree. This listener is great for script preparation, but make sure to disable it for real test runs. It consumes too many system resources. We can click the green button to start the test, then on the ViewResultsTree listener, and you can now watch the test progress. If all the green marks show up, we're good to go. The summary report shows aggregated statistics in real time. The test stops when we click the red stop button. We can delete the results by pressing the button with the broom. By navigating to SmartMeter Test, disabling enabling static resources, you can easily disable and enable static resources. Once you have your test set up and ready to go, it can be started with the red start button. This will start a new instance of SmartMeter.io and offers greater stability and performance than the traditional green button start.